गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट,
गुड आफ्टरनून
लास्ट
मैम।
क्लास वी कंसीडर वन टाइप ऑफ कंटीन्यूअस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, दैट इज द नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। सो आई टोल्ड यू दैट एनी नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन प्रोबेबिलिटी डेंसिटी फंक्शन ऑफ दैट नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। Then we compute the value of the mean and the standard deviation. So mean of the normal distribution is mu, and the standard deviation is sigma. Variance is obviously sigma square. Now after that, I told you the next concept, that is the standard normal distribution. So it is a particular case of the normal distribution when the mu is zero and sigma is one. So okay, we will consider some problems related to this. So as I already told you, whenever we have to solve some problem, then we mainly use the standard normal distribution. And again, I already told you the rule to rule by which you can just change the normal distribution to standard normal distribution. Okay, so today we will consider some problem. So first problem is, the first one is the problem. Write down the problem. If capital X
ma'am, your voice is cracking.
Write down the problem. If capital X is normally distributed, with mean 3, and standard deviation 2. Okay, so mainly you have to just read the instruction carefully. Standard deviation is given or variance is given. If standard deviation is given, then the value is sigma. If variance is given, then the value is sigma square. Okay, so here standard deviation is given and it is 2. So if X is normally distributed with mean 3 and standard deviation 2, find C such that probability of X greater than C is equal to 2 probability of X less than equals to 6. Okay, some values are given. X is normally distributed with, this is your mean, this is your standard deviation. So you have to find one C so that this condition satisfies.
Ma'am, can you repeat?
Sorry?
Can you repeat, ma'am?
Yes. If capital X is normally distributed, with mean 3, and standard deviation 2, sine t, sine t such that this condition holds. Probability A greater than C is equal to probability of A less than equal to C. Okay. And another condition is given, that is minus infinity to 0.43 phi of t dt is equals to 1/3. One value is given. We have to actually use this value to solve the to actually find the value of C. So we have to mainly use all these known formulas here. So here you can see minus infinity to 0.43 phi of t dt is given. Okay, it is actually the standard normal distribution. Standard normal distribution is represented by phi of x. So it is given. One particular value is given of the standard normal distribution. So if you remember, in the last class, I already told you the formula by which we can transform the normal distribution to the standard normal distribution. Okay. So what is the main formula? It is x minus z is equal to x minus mu by sigma. Okay, it is the rule to transform any normal variate. It is called normal variate and it is called standard normal variate. So by this rule, you can change the normal variate into standard normal variate. So x is the variate, okay. Mean is given, it is 3 and standard deviation is 2. So you can put this value here. So x minus 3 by 2. Now, one extra condition is also given, that probability x greater than c is equal to 2 probability x less than equal to. So we already transferred the x normal variate to the standard normal variate. So we also have to change this condition also. So probability of x greater than c is equal to 2 probability of x less than equal to c. You can write this as probability of, we mainly require to change this x into z. How can you change this? Z means x minus 3 by 2. So in place of x, you have to write x minus 3 by 2. So if you consider x minus 3 by 2, x minus 3, this will be greater than c minus 3. I'm just transferring this relation, probability of x greater than c, into the z standard normal variate z. Okay, so we require this form, so that's why I'm just subtracting 3 from x from the both of this side. And you already know, if any inequality sign is given and if you subtract same thing from this both side, then value will not change. So we can write this. Now again, we want this divided by 2, so here it is divided by 2, it is divided. So this is changed into this. Okay. So this can be written as probability of z greater than c minus 3 by. Okay. So in this way, you have to first change this is the standard normal variate into standard normal variate. It is very easy. First, you have to find the relationship between them. It is the formula. Just put the values of mean and standard deviation. After that, you have to just change this x into z and in any inequality sign, you can subtract the same thing from both the side. You can add the same thing from both the side. You can multiply the same thing in the both of the side. Okay, but the values does not change. So first x minus 3, so it will be greater than c minus 3. Next x minus 3 by 2, it will be c minus 3 by 2, and this value is z. So probability is z greater than c minus 3 by 2. Okay, now we have to find this value first. Probability z greater than c minus 3 by 2. Probability z greater than c minus 3 by 2. Okay. Now, one relation is given, but we want to use, we want to find the different value of this probability. After that, we will equal the result with this, with the given right hand side. Okay. So the probability of z greater than c minus 3 by 2 can be written as, obviously, 1 minus probability of z less than equals to c minus 3 by 2 complementary event. You already know probability of A is equal to 1 minus probability of A complement. So obviously, if z is greater than c minus 3 by 2, its complementary event will be less than equals to c minus 3 by 2. Okay. So this can be written as 1 minus probability z less than equals to c minus 3 by 2. So standard normal variate, the value of this is less than c minus 3 by 2 means from minus infinity to upper limit c minus 3 by 2, phi of t dt. Since this is standard normal variate and probability of z less than equals to c minus 3 by 2 means, this type of probability you already considered in the distribution chapter. Okay, now let's copy this portion. Okay. Now, this is equals to 2 probability of x less than equals to 3. It is given that probability of z greater, probability of x greater than 3 is equals to 2 probability of x less than equals to 3. First, I found the value of the left hand side. Now, I found the value of the right hand side. Okay. So, again, this will be written as probability of x, sorry, it is c, x minus 3 by 2 less than equals to c minus 3 by 2. This is your z. So 2 probability of z less than equals to c minus 3 by 2. Okay. Again, z less than equals to c minus 3 by 2 means 2 integration minus infinity to c minus 3 by 2 I of t dt. We apply the same concept. First, we found the value of left hand side, then we found the value of right hand side.
मैम अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ।
Okay, so first we found the value of the left hand side, then we found the value of the right hand side. Now, according to the question, left hand side is equal to right hand side. So from this, you can see this value is equal to this value. So 1 is equal to, if I take this one here, so 2 plus this will be 3 into minus infinity to 2 minus 3 by 2 I of t d. You can take, see that this integration is same with this integration. Here the coefficient is 2, here it is 1. So if you add this to integration, you will get 3 into minus infinity to c minus 3 by 2 I of t d. Now, what is the value of this? Obviously, it will be 1 by 3 is equal to minus infinity to c minus 3 by 2 phi of t dt. Okay. Now, again, take the question. In the question, they give you one value of the integration. That is minus infinity to 0.43 phi of t dt is equals to 1 by 3. Now compare this to these two integration. Values are same, 1 by 3, 1 by 3, phi of t dt, phi of t dt. Lower limits are also same. Upper limit obviously must be same. So t minus 3, comparing both equation, c minus 3 by 2 is equal to 0.4. Okay. So from this, c is equal to 3 plus, if you cross multiply this, you will get 0.86. 0.86 answer will be 3.86. This is the not difficult, you can see that. It is actually very easy. You have to simply change the normal variate into standard normal variate. Relations are given. Relations are given, that is x minus mu by sigma. And mu and values of mu and sigma also given in your question. So you can easily get the transformation rule. Okay. After that, first you have to find the value of the left hand side, that is probability x greater than 6. So I already told you, whenever we have to consider any problem of normal distribution, we have to change it to standard normal distribution. So simply you have to change the x into x minus 3 by 2. Okay? So if you consider x minus 3 by 2 in the left hand side, then in the right hand side it will be c minus 3 by 2. So first find the value of the left hand side, then have value of the right hand side, and according to the question they are equal. So from this you will get this relation. Okay, and again in the question, one value of the integration is given. So comparing these two integration, you can easily solve the value of t. So it is a question of 2007. Next question. Next question, write down the question. if capital X is normally distributed, if capital X is normally distributed, if capital X is normally distributed with zero mean, with zero mean, unit variance. If X is normally distributed with mean zero and variance unit variance, if X is normally distributed with zero mean and unit variance, then find the expectation of X squared. Find the expectation of X squared. Find the expectation of X. And it is a question of 2002 and 2007. It is very easy to find the value of X squared. You only have to use the mean and the standard deviation to find the expectation of X squared. Tell me, what is the value of expectation of X? What will be the value of expectation of X squared? It is given, it is normally distributed and mean is zero and standard deviation is one. If standard deviation is one, then obviously, oh no, variance is one. If standard deviation is also one, then variance is also one. Or if variance is one, then standard deviation is one. No problem in that. So variance of X is equals to one. So what is the formula of variance of X? Expectation of X square minus expectation of X whole square is equal to 1. Implies expectation of X square minus expectation of X whole square. Expectation of X means the mean. So it will be 0 square, 0. So value of expectation of X square is equal to 1. Even from this, they can also ask you what is the value of expectation of X into X minus 1. This can, this also can be, can you can just find using the another formula of variance. I hope you already remember this formula, that is the expectation of x into x minus 1 minus m into m minus 1, which we use to find the variance of binomial distribution and Poisson distribution. Okay, so they can also ask you for find the value of expectation of x into x minus 1. So this is the second problem, and last problem of normal distribution is write down the problem. If the weekly wage of 10,000 workers, if the weekly wage of 10,000 workers, if the weekly wage of 10,000 workers in a factory follows normal distribution, with mean and standard deviation, ₹70 and ₹5 respectively, okay. If the weekly wage of 10,000 workers, if the weekly wage of 10,000 workers in a factory follows normal distribution with mean and standard deviation, ₹70 and ₹5 respectively, find the expected number of workers, find the expected number of workers whose weekly wages are number 1 between ₹66 and ₹72. Whose weekly wages are between ₹66 and ₹72. Less than rupees sixty six. and number 3 more than rupees 72. More than rupees 72. So this is the total question. I repeat the question again. If the weekly wages of 10,000 workers in a factory follows normal distribution with mean and standard deviation rupees 70 and 5 respectively, means the mean is 70 and standard deviation is 5, then find the expected number of workers whose weekly wages are number 1 between rupees 66 and rupees 72, number 2 rupees less than rupees 66, number 3 more than rupees 72. Okay, so it is a question of 2006. Okay, so one more value are given again, like the first problem. Some values are given. What are the values? 1 by root over 2 pi, 0 to z, e to the power minus t square by 2 dt is equal to 0.1554. And 0.2881 according as z is equal to 0.4 and z is equal to 0.8. Given that 1 by root over 2 pi 0 to z e to the power minus t square by 2 dt is equal to 0.1554 and 0.2881. According as z is equal to 0.4, z is equal to 0.8. Means same type of value of integration is given when z is 0.4, means 0 to 0.4 e to the power minus t square, this total value will be 0.1554. And if z is 0.8, then the value will be 0.2881. So this is the total problem. So first read the question properly. After that, I will solve the problem. So if the weekly wages of 10,000 workers are normally distributed, so you can see each and every problem, they will mention you whether it is normally distributed or it is Poisson distribution or it is binomial distribution. Okay, so here of 10,000 workers follow the normal distribution where mean is 70 and standard deviation is 5. Standard here, the value of standard deviation is given. So find the expected number of workers whose weekly wages rise between 66 to 72, then less than 66, more than 70. This problem mainly consists of 3 parts. So one by one we have to solve. First thing, obviously, in the last line you can see some values of standard normal distributions are given. Okay, means integration e to the power minus t square by 2. This is the probability density function of standard normal distribution. So again, for this problem also, we have to change the x into z. Okay. So what is the relation between x and z? Z is equals to x minus mu by sigma. So x is minus mu means 70, sigma means height. So this is the rule to transform the x into z. So z is equal to x minus 75 by 5. X is normal variant, z is standard normal variant. Okay. Now in the question they ask you find the expected number of workers whose weekly wages lies between 56 and 72. Means they ask you what is the probability of workers whose wages lie between 66 to 72, 66 less than x less than 72. Obviously, the value of x is given in the question. Now you have to change the value of x into z. Okay, so how can you change the value? Obviously, you have to use the same process. Probability of first you every point each and every value you have to subtract 70. First 66 minus 70 means minus 4. Less than x minus 70 less than 70 minus 72 minus 7. Okay, I am subtracting 70 from each and every value. 66 minus 70 is minus 4. X minus 70, 72 minus 70 is 2. Now you require x minus 70 by 5. So divide it by. So obviously, this will give you probability of minus 4 by 5 means 0 minus 0.8 minus 0.8 less than x minus 70 by 5 means z less than 2 by 5 means 0.2. Now you have to find the value of this probability. Probability 0 minus 0.8 less than z less than 0.2. Now, you already know this type of probability also. What is the value of this type of probability? The value of z lies between minus 0.8 to 0.4. So obviously, this is minus 0.8 to 0.4. This z means phi of t. The probability density function of the standard normal. You have to now find the value of d. Okay. Now to find this value, you required some value. So in question, you can see two values are given. One is from 0 to 0.8, another is 0 to 0.4. So we have to now use this value to find the value of this integration. So first, I'm breaking this total interval minus 0.8 to 0.4 into two intervals. One is minus 0.8 to 0 phi of t dt. Plus another is 0.0 to 0.4 phi of t dt. Okay, so you already know this estimate probability density function of standard normal variance. And what is the probability density function of standard normal variance? It is 1 by root over 2 pi e to the power minus e square by 2. So in question, you can say the value is given, but here it is 0 to minus 0.8. But in the question, 0 to 0.8 is given, and here minus 0.8 to 0 is given. We require this value. Now, you need to draw the graph of the normal distribution. So in normal distribution, last day also I draw the graph of normal and standard normal distribution. So in standard normal distribution, mu is equal to zero, you already know. So the curve looks like this, and I already told you this curve is symmetrical with respect to this y-axis. So this is suppose zero, this here you have 0.8, here obviously you have minus 0.8. So if you know what is the geometrical interpretation of integration, then integration mainly determines the area of the bounded region, okay, area of by integration, you can find the area of the region. So by this integration, minus 0.8 to 0, you can find this area, this whole area, okay? And since it is symmetrical with respect to this y-axis, this area will be equal with this area. That's why it is symmetrical. So you can obviously write in place of minus 0.8 to 0, you can obviously write 0 to 0.8, because this is symmetrical with respect to y-axis, and this area is equal to this area. So in place of this integration, you can find 0 to 0.3 pi of t. So first integration is 0 to 0.8 pi of t dt plus 0 to 0.4. I of t. You don't require to change this one because you already have the value of this integration. We only require to change the limit of the first integration. Okay, so now we already have this value. So for the value at 0.8 is 0.2881 plus, and at 0.4, it is 0.1552. If you add this, you will get 5344. But this is not the answer. So we now find the value of the probability that the wage of a worker lies between rupees 66 to 70. Now in the first line, you can see that there are total 10,000 workers. So this is the wage for one worker. So for 10,000 workers, the wage will be 10,000 into 0.443. So answer will be 443. This is the answer. Okay. By the probability, you get the weekly wage of one worker. Okay, and now since there are a total 10,000 workers, so you have to multiply the wage by 10,000. So 4435 is the required answer. Next, number two is whose weekly wages is less than rupees 60. First, copy this portion. After that, I will consider the second part. In other distribution, you need not to know the but in normal distribution, you need to know the diagram. Because in the maximum problem, using the diagram, you have to change the limit of this integration. Here, you in the first one, you can see that you have to change the value of the limit using the diagram. That's why you need to know the diagram for normal distribution. Now, second part, that is probability of F less than 66. Probability F less than 66. Again, you have to change this x into z. So, probability of x minus 70, x minus 70 by 5 less than 66 minus 70 by 5. So, 66 minus 70 minus 4 by 5. So, probability of z less than minus 0.2. Now you already know what is the value of the probability z less than minus 0.8. It is minus infinity to minus 0.8 I of t. Now again check the question. There you have only two values, that is from 0 to 0.4 and 0 to 0.8. So here also you require this type of integration, obviously. So how can you change this integration into the known form? Again, you require the part. Again, this curve is symmetrical with respect to y-axis. Okay. Minus infinity to 0.8. This is suppose minus 0.8. This is suppose 0.8. Minus infinity to minus 0.8 means this area. 0.8 to here, yeah, suppose it is minus infinity. So this integration represents the area of this portion. This is the this is symmetrical with respect to y-axis. So this area will be equal with this area. So you can write 0.8 to infinity phi of t dt. Okay, now again, you don't have the value of this integration of 0.8 to 0 to infinity. So now just remember again one thing, the property of probability density function. If you integrate the probability density function from minus infinity to infinity, then obviously you will get 1, and I already told you by integration we represent the total area. So this total area is obviously 1. Okay, it is symmetrical with respect to y-axis. So this area is 0.5, this area is 0.5, 0.5. Okay, so now if from this 0.5, if I subtract this portion, then we will get this one. Here, from the total, this total portion is 0.5. this total portion is 0.5. From this to this is 0 to 0.8 and this to this is 0.8 to infinity. Okay. So from 0.5, if I subtract this portion, so remaining will be this one. So 0.5 minus 0 to 0.8 I of t. Now you can see you already get the value. So 0 to 0.8 means 0.5 minus 0.2881. Okay, so if you subtract, you will get this is 0.211. Okay, so again, it is for one worker, for 10,000 worker, it will be rupees 211. Means 0.2119 into 10,000, that is 2119. I'll copy this part. After that, I will consider the third part. Next is the weekly wage that is greater than 70. Same process you have to apply. Probability 8 greater than 70. Again, you have to change it to Z. So 8 minus 70 by 5. Greater than 72 minus 70 by 5, obviously. So probability Z, this is your Z, greater than, this is 2 by 5. 2 by 5 means 0.4. Okay, so you can write this as 1 minus Z less than equals to 0.4, or you can directly write it. Since Z is greater than 0.4, so 0.4 is the lower limit and upper limit is obviously infinite. This I of t dt. Again, the same problem. We don't have the value of this integration. We only have the value of 0 to 0.4. So again, the same graph. This is the line of symmetry, axis of symmetry. So the area in the total area is, I already told you, since the total integration value of the total integration is 1 and this is symmetrical, this portion will be 0.5, this portion will be 0.5. Okay. Now 0.4 to infinity, suppose here it is 0.4. This negative point is 0. So 0.4 to infinity represents this area. So how can you write this? So if from 0.8 to subtract this total in this portion, then obviously you will get that remaining part from 0.5, means from this total portion, if you subtract this one, then you will get this. So you can write it as 0.5 minus 0 to 0.4 I of t dt. Now you get the required value. So the value is 0.5 minus 0.1554. And if you subtract, you will get 6, 4, 4, 0.344. Again, 14,000 workers. 14,000 workers. Three, four. If you have to multiply it by 10,000, so 10,000, 3446 is the required. So mainly, first tell me if you have any query in these three problems. In each and every problem of normal distribution mainly, they will provide you the value of the integration. In first problem also, you can see that there is a one value of integration is given. And in the third problem also, there are two values of the integration are given. So in each and every problem, they will give you some particular value. And in the what problem, they will definitely mention you which x follows which distribution. Either it is the Poisson, either it is the binomial or normal distribution. Okay. So I mainly consider three types of question. And in this third question, in examination, they can ask any one of the three cases. First case is if the wage lies between 66 to 72. So in some question, they can ask you only first part, or they can ask you only second part, or they can ask you only third part. Both are very easy. If probability is like this in this problem, probability is greater than 0.2. So if you get probability greater than 0.2, so obviously 0.4 will be the one limit of this integration. Okay. And you already know the value of the upper limit is obviously minus integer, sorry, plus integer. So this is probability z greater than 0.2. And if probability z less than 0.4 is given, so obviously the all the values of z will be less than 0.4. And lower limit is minus infinity, then you have to consider the integration minus infinity to 0.4. And if any particular value, suppose 5 to 8 is given, this means the lower limit will be 5, upper limit will be 8, and the probability density function. Here I use phi of t. Phi of t means the probability density function. And probability density function of standard normal variable is, 1 by root over 2 pi. 1 by root over 2 pi minus infinity to infinity 0 to minus infinity to infinity e to the power minus e square by 2 b. This is the probability density function which is given in your question. So you can write also this. So any more question, any question in this topic or in any question of this? So this third question is a question of 2006. You can ask me if you have any query. You don't have any queries. I just want to tell you one small concept. That is, if you already know the binomial distribution, so the probability mass function binomial distribution is a discrete distribution. That's why it has probability mass function. So n ci p to the power I q to the power n minus I, this is the probability mass function of binomial theorem. So if suppose this n is very large, this n is very large and this p is not very small, if p is not very small, then z is equals to capital X minus np by root over np into 1 minus p approaches to standard normal distribution. Okay, from this concept they will not ask you any numerical problem. They can only ask you the MCQ if n is very large and p is not very small, then binomial distribution approaches to whose distribution, either Poisson or here. So answer will be standard normal distribution. If n is equal to x minus np by root over np into 1 minus p, this approaches standard normal distribution, and this z is called the standard binomial. Standard binomial. This z is called standard binomial value. Okay, where this standard binomial variate has the mean, it is the mean, and the denominator is the actually standard difference. You have to only remember this from this concept. If n is very large and p is not very small, then the binomial distribution approaches to standard normal distribution, and mainly it is called the standardized binomial variate with mean np and standard deviation root over n root over np q, since 1 minus p means q, so it is np q. Okay, so since you don't have any queries, so see you in the next class. Thank you. I'm ending this session.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.